So here in this video we will study about the various zones of the physis and the various type of the ossification that we have in our body. So starting with the anatomy of the physis, so we have the various zones. So there are broadly three zones. We have the reserve zone, we have the proliferative zone, we have the hypertrophic zone. The hypertrophic part is further divided into three zones: the zone of maturation, zone of degeneration, and provisional calcification. So from our basic knowledge of anatomy, we know that the part of the bone that articulates with the joint is known as epiphysis. The part where the growth occurs is known as physis, and the rest of the broader part is known as the metaphysis. So we have the various zones of physis. We have the germinal or the resting zone. We have the proliferative zone. This is from epiphysis to the metaphysis. We have the hypertrophic zone, and in hypertrophic we have three zones. We have the zone of maturation, zone of degeneration, and provisional calcification. So one by one we will study it. So starting with the reserve zone. So as the name indicates, it is basically a storage zone. There is no blood supply, so no growth occur at this level. The cells in these levels, they store the lipids, glycogen, and the proteoglycans. So this is the germinal or resting zone. So it contains chondrocytes, which are the in resting phase, which supply the proliferative zone. So these resting phase chondrocytes, they are involved in the proliferative zone. Once these chondrocytes proceed to hypertrophic zone, the more chondrocytes from the reserve zone enter the proliferative zone. So this is about the germinal zone. They contain chondrocytes in resting phase, replenishes the proliferative zone, and injury in this zone causes cessation of the growth. Now coming about to the second zone, which is the proliferative zone. So here the chondrocytes are in division mitosis. So in this zone, proliferative one, there occur matrix and the cellular proliferation. So chondrocytes here are in mitosis, they keep on divided and they produce the matrix and the more chondrocytes. So it has abundant blood supply. So for growth we need abundant blood supply. So here the blood supply is increased and the oxygen tension is also increased. So it has abundant blood supply and it is responsible for the increase in the bone length. Plus injury on this zone causes cessation of the growth also. So this is about the second zone, which is the proliferative zone, which is a matrix and the cellular proliferation occur. Blood supply is increased because mitosis is occurring, oxygen tension is more. Now coming upon to the third type of the zone, which is the hypertrophic zone, which is further divided into maturation, degeneration, and the provisional calcification. Now in the first two, there occur preparation of the matrix, whereas in the third, the actual calcification part occur in the third zone. So the hypertrophic zone, here the cells, they accumulate the glycogen and lipids. It is the weakest zone and it is the site of physis fracture. And in third zone of the calcification, the mineralization of the matrix occur and there is infiltration of the metaphyseal blood vessels. So here in this zone, the matrix is prepared and calcification of the matrix occur in this provisional calcification zone. Now from proliferative zone to the calcification zone, the blood supply sequentially decreases, the oxygen tension also decreases. Now talking about the various disorders or injuries that occur in the specific zone. So reserve zone, the various lysosomal diseases like Gaucher's disease, they affect this zone. Now proliferative zone, it is under the influence of growth hormone. So achondroplasia or any gigantism, it occurs in the proliferative zone. Now coming upon to the third type of hypertrophic zone. So we have the enchondroma, we have the skiffy, and the rickets. Rickets is the disease of calcification. And physis fracture. They occur in the hypertrophic zone because it is a weak zone. Now, after this physis area, metaphysis started. So, the cells which have got calcified here will results in the bone formation in the metaphyseal region. So, metaphysis has two zones. We have the primary spongiosa and the secondary spongiosa. So, in the primary spongiosa, the calcified cells, they under the influence of the vascular invasion, they lead to the formation of the woven bone. So, we know, we have studied in the previous videos, woven bone is an immature bone which is remodeled in the secondary spongiosa, leading to the lamellar bone. Now, here again, metaphyseal blood supply is increased. So, sequentially, it is increased from primary to secondary zone. And also, oxygen tension is also increased. Now, scurvy is a disease of metaphysis and it involves the primary spongiosa, to be specific. So, this was about the various zones of the physis and the zones of the metaphysis. So, important thing to remember is here the physial fractures which occur in the hypertrophic zone, rickets which occur in the hypertrophic zone, scurvy which occur in the metaphysis. Now, talking about the various type of the ossification. So, we know that we have the two type of the ossification, end control ossification and the intramembranous ossification. So, end control is basically a type of ossification where the cartilage formation first occur and later on the deposition of the bone occur. So, a type of ossification taking place from centers arising in the cartilage and involving the deposition of the lime salt in the cartilage matrix, followed by secondary absorption and replacement by the true bony tissue. So, it is the cartilage is not converted into bone, it is the cartilage is resorbed and it is replaced by the bony tissue. In intramembranous, it is directly bone formation, development of the osseous tissue, bony tissue within the mesenchymal tissue without the prior cartilage formation. So here a cartilage is formed first and then bone is laid down. But here in intramembranous ossification, bone is directly formed from the mesenchymal cells. So proceed through an intermediate cartilage, here no cartilage is formed. So it is important in the formation of the long bones because growth occur. So this is also an example of end control ossification, where firstly a cartilaginous process occur and later a bone formation occur. So it is important in the formation of the long bones, whereas it is important in the formation of the flat bones. It usually takes a longer time to form a bone, it takes less time to form a bone. So it stops at the age of 2 years, but it stops at the age of 18 to 21 years, depending on male or female. Now, so we have studied that end control bony ossification is a example of the physial growth. Now, what all are the other example of the end control ossification? So, where the cases where there is cast application or there is healing with the help of intramedullary nailing. So, in those cases where there is non-rigid fixation, the ossification, it occurs by the end control ossification with the help of callus formation. Whereas intramembranous, it occurs in cases where there is a rigid fixation, like in a compression plate or in cases of destruction histogenesis in Lizarov or LRS. So in those cases, the intramembranous ossification occurs. So where directly a bone is laid down. So another table to classify and differentiate the intramembranous and the end control ossification. So again here, embryonic mesenchyma forms a collagen membrane containing osteochondral progenitor cell. So it, to begin with, it has a osteochondral progenitor cell. Here a cartilage template is formed first because the embryonic mesenchymal cell, they first develop into chondroblast. which produce a cartilage membrane. The chondrocytes, they occur hypertrophy, the cartilage membranes become calcified, and then the chondrocyte die. And here the osteoblast comes. The blood vessel and the osteoblast, they form a periosteum. From the periosteum, they invade the calcified cartilage template. And osteoclasts form a spongy bone at the primary ossification center, and later at the secondary ossification center. Now here, it is directly the osteoblast forming the bone. So that was about the anatomy of the physis, the various zones of the physis, and the various type of the ossification center.